In the beginning, it was not written, but it was wanted, and it was spoken, and it was done. It was wanted and spoken and done by God. He spoke, and it was so, completely so, the way he wanted it to be, the way it ought to be. All he wanted to make and give to the living, he talked about in the beginning. He is a Lord God whose word is like unto his deed. He said, and it was so, completely so. By his word, he is able to set worlds into order, put fish into the water, angels into heaven, his image into Bethlehem, and man into everlasting life. His word causes men to answer him in their own words. Men come before God. He hears the confessions of his people. The noise of stars rushing, atoms bursting, and whole planets exploding does not distort the confessions of people. The noise of an earth full of motors roaring, and ships and planes and buses, and billions of children and women and men talking out loud and thinking at the same time, does not distort the confessions of men. sounds of every description surrounding the earth and all planets, sounding in the sky and in the waters, and in the spaces between planets, is no louder to him than secret thoughts and desires and beliefs. The word of God came quietly into a little town and into one woman, and has become like a mighty crescendo in the ears and eyes and hearts of men. Generations upon generations have come close to lean over the event, saying,
keeping watch.
His ministry began in the beginning, as he made the line across galaxies and the line between light and darkness, and that creative distance which he left between male and female. The ministry continued as he waited in line to be born, and he was a newborn. He walked in the line that led to the temple at the Passover. He was 12. He waited in a line once more on the bank of the river to be baptized by a man clad in camel's hair and a leather girdle about his waist. It was all in the presence of God and in the midst of men. In the wilderness, his host was Satan. By now, it was declared by God and by Satan that here was a new man upon the earth. His word and his deed were toward people. His word and his deed were toward people. Two brothers mending their nets. The woman sick with fever. The leper. The paralytic. The house full of people. Sinners, religious leaders, a man with a withered hand, a great multitude, all who had diseases. The 12 he chose for special moments. His mother, his brothers, a very large crowd, a demoniac living among the tombs, a terrified churchman, a bleeding woman, weeping people, a dead child. Worshippers. It was a new man upon the earth, and he created a new work among people upon the earth. They describe their new work with the words